Hi, everyone. My name is Amber Talbot. I'm the director with the PAWS More Animal Shelter in Washington, Iowa. Thank you for attending today. I'm excited to talk to you about our Dog Day Adventure Program. This particular study was an extension of research that Maddie's Fund had already been working on that had showed that one night away from a shelter had decreased levels of stress for our shelter dogs. And we were so excited to partner with this program and be accepted. And we were just one of 100 shelters across the United States participating in the study. And we were the smallest one and the only Iowa shelter. The apprenticeship was a fun part of the study. A staff member and an employee were able to attend the Charlottesville SPCA. There, they were able to handle shelter dogs, work with shelter dogs, and participate in the dog field trip program in real life. They also got to have an opportunity to take a shelter dog for a sleepover and provide promotional materials for that dog. I hope you can follow the link below to check out their YouTube video that they made. So determining what dogs are candidates in your shelter, there are a wide range of considerations, and it really depends on your shelter's policies. Here is an example of the criteria that our shelter was comfortable with putting together. There are lots of resource links at the end of the slideshow here that we'll share with you. You guys can do whatever is comfortable for your shelter and makes sense for you and the dogs that are in your care. As you can see from the criteria for who are candidates, there's not a lot of criteria. You must be 18 years of age or older and fill out proper documentation. Other than that, the focus of this program really is to remove barriers and create a different culture than we've seen in the last couple decades with animal sheltering. And while letting down barriers does not mean that you still cannot have a safe program with proper rules in place. Some simple rules that our shelter came up with that were important to us was to use appropriate leashes, no retractable leashes, of course, and that our dogs always needed to be kept on leash at all times. One of the key components that was a requirement for us when we launched our program that was part of the rules was that all dogs needed to not be in contact with other dogs. So it was really important that people participating in the study and also going forward when the study was complete, that they did not have our shelter dog interacting with their pets at home or at dog parks or walking with friends on leash together. And of course, paying attention to the dog's comfort level. If you're in a busy store shopping and the dog is feeling stressed, then we want people to be aware of that and take appropriate action at that time to make sure our animals are safe and happy and enjoying the experience. One of the fun benefits of this program is it really allows you to establish even deeper partnerships with your local businesses. These last two slides, you've noticed this dog is at a coffee shop, and we partnered with our local coffee shop, and they did discounted coffees for people participating in the program. And while they did that, they also offered free puppuccinos for our dogs. So that was a really fun way to get engagement as well. So once someone comes to check out a dog at our shelter, you are given a backpack with a water bottle, poop bags, treats, collapsible water bowl, information sheet about pet-friendly places to attend, including local participating businesses. They also have information about the dog to help facilitate an adoption if they are out and about in the community and someone would have a question. We're pretty much preparing everyone with all the right tools they need to be safe. And in this slide, we have our local radio station program director who was able to take the dog to her office for the afternoon, and she was able to broadcast with the dog there in her studio all day, which really created tons of engagement and a tremendous opportunity to feature that dog. It was a huge success and a fun afternoon for them both. So the whole purpose of this program and getting shelters to implement dog field trips and sleepovers is to really decrease stress in our shelter dogs and to help get more dogs into loving homes through engagement and community involvement. And these are the proven benefits that have been shown now through various studies and the current one that we participated in. There was tremendous benefit in all of these categories. Louisville Metro Animal Services is one great example of how their program was a success. Being able to cut behavioral euthanasia in half and having over 70 dogs find homes as a direct result of the program that wouldn't have otherwise is a perfect example of why this program is a huge benefit and will benefit your dogs in care as well. Here is a quote from the director of the Louisville Metro Animal Services. Field trip fostering has brought a whole new group of people to our shelter that would have never visited otherwise. Over 80% of people attending field trip orientations had never stepped foot in our facility. The idea of getting to hang out with a dog and not have to make a long-term commitment has drawn people to us. This truly is a feel-good program, and PAWS More has seen it with our own eyes. We've had 109 field trips since last May. It has been a tremendous success. People love the opportunity to spend time with the dog without the commitment. And I would say 70% of people that participated in our field trips were not people that would have come to the shelter otherwise because they were not able to do long-term fostering and they were not in the position to adopt, but they were able to spend time with a dog. The other benefit to this program is that it also allows you to learn more about your dogs that are in care. This stems far beyond just community involvement and partnerships and cultivation. This truly helps you learn more about your dogs. And we have individuals fill out a report card when they return to the shelter that shows us what activities they participated in and how the dog reacted to those different situations. And as I mentioned before, I cannot stress enough how this really opens the door for you to empower your community to get involved. So many people feel that they can't help shelters because they can't donate, they can't foster, and they can't adopt. Those are the three major things that I hear routinely. And this program allows them to still help when they don't have the time to volunteer and they can't afford to adopt. This also is a great way to feature your dogs. When your dog is walking through a store with Adopt Me apparel on, or going jogging on a nature trail, or just walking downtown in your community, it prompts people to ask questions, and a conversation is how it starts. And we saw so much positive feedback when our dogs were out in our communities. It really drew people in, and it pushed them to ask questions. And through the engagement and community support of our field trip program, it brought people into our shelter that could do more than a field trip. And we were able to increase our foster base for a variety of other needs, including kitten care. Thank you so much for the opportunity to share this amazing program with you guys. Here are some links for you to check out. Maddie's Fund is probably the greatest resource and has a whole toolkit here, marketing strategies and also various different obstacles that your shelter might encounter. Maddie's Fund is a great resource to empower you to do this. They have all the tools here for you to implement this program just like we did. Thank you.